Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and today I will show you how you can clean up that Xcode junk. So without further ado, let's get to work. Okay, now if you are working on multiple projects, then you will find out very quickly that your storage on your Mac will run out. And of course, that is because Xcode takes up a lot of data. Now, you can and you should occasionally clean that data. Now, I will show you what you need to do. Okay, first of all, is you should download an app called Dr. Cleaner from the Mac App Store. And that is a free app. Of course, you can upgrade if you wish, but for our purposes, this is fine. So go ahead. Of course, you can clean up all of your junk files, but I will go and select System Optimizer now and select Scan under Junk Files. And I have deliberately chosen this path so I may show you that Xcode really takes up a lot of space. Now, as you can see, I have 5.676 gigabytes of Xcode junk. Of course, I will delete that. And this will vary, of course, according to your Xcode usage. So I will just click on remove and it is cleaning junk files and you will have cleaned that Xcode junk file. Okay, let's wait for that and see what we can do next, because these are basically all temporary files that Xcode saves. Okay, let's click on, let's move out of our application here. Okay, next up is you want to manage your Xcode junk manually. So to do that, open up your Finder and you need to go to your developer library, and it is fairly easy. Select Go, and of course you will not have this library available for you, but if you just hit Alt, you can just simply toggle the library. So hit Alt and then select Library. Okay, and you will be taken to your library folder. Okay, now, first of all, you might want to delete your provisioning profiles. They don't really take up much of your space, but it is a good thing. So go ahead and scroll down and select mobile devices and provisioning profiles and delete all of them. There are just a few here, so I won't bother doing this now. So what you should really do is go under developer, and here we have our core simulator. Now here we have our devices. Now you could delete all of your devices if you have a lot of them. Now, because I have previously deleted them and installed the latest iOS 12 devices, I have only just a few, and this is of course installed automatically when you start up Xcode. So go ahead, if you have a lot of them here, then delete all of them and open up Xcode. Now let's go and select, here we go, Xcode. Yeah, and here's the big data, archives. Now, there are a lot of archives. If you upload to App Store, then you just know that there are a lot of archives. And as you can see in your box, a lot of archives, and this takes up a lot of place. So I will just select all of them and move to trash. Okay, next up is derived data. Now, derived data is basically when you create or launch a project in Xcode, this is created for easy caching. So I will delete all of that. And of course, you may take a look at how big these files are in your case. Okay, I believe that is it. cache, device logs, support. Now this is support for your iOS 11, and you should leave this alone if you don't have too much files here. And next up is our products. Okay, I will go ahead and take a look at this. Yeah, I will not delete products because they are, well, basically the products that I have created. Of course, if you want a huge clean, then go ahead and delete products too. Okay, user data. Here we have our code snippets. If you are interested, you can find that in here. Font and color themes. Of course, I have created my default Rebeloper here. Okay, and that is it, but you have set aside a lot of junk Xcode. This is a basic cleanup of Xcode, but you most probably got rid of most, if not all, of the junk file that you have in Xcode. Now that is it for this short tutorial. Go ahead and give it a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell to get notified when I upload new videos, and I do upload it on a regular basis. Now it's your turn. Do let me know in the comments down below, how often do you need to clean your Xcode junk files, and if you do have another tip on how to clean your Xcode junk files, go ahead and share it down below in the comments. Okay, that is it for me for this tutorial, and as always, I will see you in the next one.